It's weird having to talk about it because I'm like, you should just watch it, go see it. It's hard to talk about it, but I'm just glad that it's finished.
You've said in the past you're not putting out more music, which sounds insane now because we now completely get why you were doing what you were doing.
Okay, yes. When I watched the film, which was after I'd retired, after the AIM album, and then to hear my grandma talk about it, then I was like, you know, but she also says like this, pointing at the camera, so she also is talking about film editing. So yeah, that was nice to be like, because I never seen that footage because I didn't really register it because I never shot, you know, I'm not holding the camera, I think my mom.
In the music industry in particular, people are like, she's angst and she's just a rebel with a cause. Why is she always angst? But this documentary, I don't know if you realise this, it's really put everything into context, and now when you actually have to listen to the music differently, because it all was definitely not style over substance. There was always substance behind it. So you must feel so happy, one, as a documentary maker, two, as her best friend.
Yeah, I do. It wasn't a case that I just wanted to chase down all of her critics and go, oh, you said that about her, let me show you the bit of footage where that's not true or whatever. That wasn't the motive for making the film. But I do think there's a sort of misunderstanding when people from other cultures and other backgrounds want to talk about their past and that they're not bringing it as a kind of a set of medals and achievements, that actually there's a real need to express yourself as an artist, to say these things. And it's not always just for the clicks or for the points or for the fans. It's, you know, back to the real roots of being an artist is needing to just process things through making work.
What a challenge though, as a documentary maker. I recently said I want to make documentaries, and then I imagine when you've got to like cut it down to that time, how much amazing content was there that you were fighting with? How can I get this in, but I've got to leave it out, I've got no space left.
There's a good another 3-4 feature films that could, you know, fell on the cutting room floor. When I first started it, it was funded by the record label, and we filmed loads of different collaborators and celebrities and made that kind of very glossy style talking heads.
I think you had Kanye too.
Yeah,
I want to see that book.
Yes, well, maybe we will, but it's just, it didn't, seeing lots of people talk about her is very different to seeing her talk for herself. And that's what I really tried to do. My voice isn't in the documentary very much. It's not a kind of director's documentary. It's more like I curated the material and stitched it together, things that she'd filmed of herself and quite personal video diary stuff, and just picked and chose different things that I thought were unusual or gave her context or, you know, revealed something that you haven't seen before in other music documentaries.
I think as a documentary maker, I know it's your first one properly, you've got an actor, and I guess it helps because you know the person. But having said that, I don't know how you managed to be impartial, because you balanced it. You absolutely showed her having her moments when you were, so you didn't have it all like roast into glasses. That must have been so difficult, because I know the protective friend of you would have wanted her to be seen in the best light possible.
I think the time that I made it, there was this explosion in kind of social justice thinking and kids on Tumblr talking about issues and being woken up to activism, and that helped me. Like reading lots of that stuff, even though I'm from a slightly older generation, the idea that some people found Maya problematic and were discussing, you know, things that they found didn't chime and the difficulties that they had with her, that was really helpful to sort of put a documentary together that sort of made sure that I showed the whole picture, like the stumbles as well as the successes, and really addressed, I think, as much as I could in 90 minutes.
You showed Diplo and Maya's relationship in a way we've never seen before. You know, we've seen the spats, we've seen them kind of be supportive of each other, but it was so cool to see them just chilling, making music, and she's just said like this. But was that a difficult decision to make, because you know it's been out there so much?
No, it's weird because in my mind, you wouldn't believe the amount of footage that I didn't put in of that stuff. Basically, they, for some reason, every single iChat, when they were, you know, as a couple, they were in different countries all the time, so they were communicating over iChat or whatever you call it, iMovie, and so many of them are recorded, and you know, you get the good, bad and the other, and you know, I didn't want to make a movie about her private life, you know, boyfriend, girlfriend kind of stuff, and then the breakup and who cheated on who and blah blah blah.
Your best friend has just said that she's going to make music again, she's coming out of retirement, and your documentary and those, that footage with her grandmother, it's a big reason why. How does that feel?
It feels great. I knew she would. Yeah.